This is the story of how John Wayne Gacy launched the career of Hangover director Todd Phillips. If you've ever seen movies such as 2019's The Joker, 2016's War Dogs, or more, you're familiar with the work of Hollywood movie director Todd Phillips. What you might not be aware of is the fact that notorious serial killer John Wayne Gacy, dubbed the killer clown known to have murdered at least 33 young men and boys throughout the 1970s, funded Phillips' early cinematic project Hated, G.G. Allen and the Murder Junkies. The film marked then NYU junior Todd Phillips' directorial debut amidst production. The project itself is about the life of G.G. Allen, the infamous pseudo-rock star known for his onstage antics, characterized by assaulting fans, open drug use, indecent exposure, defecation, self-mutilation, and constant threats of mid-performance suicide. The film also featured footage surrounding G.G. Allen's accidental overdose in 1993, which took place during the post-production of the film. However, none of this would have been possible without John Wayne Gacy. G.G. Allen had a fascination with serial killers, often stating that he likely would have become one were it not for his rock and roll career. Allen often visited and wrote to Gacy, though little was documented about what they discussed. Aware of this relationship and in planning for the film's production, Todd Phillips reached out to Gacy for assistance on the venture. Gacy, known for his affinity for intricate, often lewd paintings that to this day are put on display in various museums, agreed to do the poster art for the film. His stipulations to Phillips were for, quote, $50 for art supplies and a compromising photo of yourself. Phillips agreed. Though he says the photo he sent to Gacy wasn't naked, it was rather provocative. Phillips then proceeded to sell copies of the poster for $15 each outside of the Maximum Rock and Roll venue. As a result of Gacy's help, who Phillips quotes as, quote, basically the executive producer, the necessary $12,000 was raised in order to create the film that launched his career. In December 1999, Hated was released on DVD and included a number of bonuses that didn't make the original version. Additional features included footage of the last show Allen performed in New York City on the evening before his death, the band rehearsal session before it, and the chaos that followed the concert being shut down. Hated was also re-released with new footage in 2007, and as an added benefit, the first 5,000 copies came with free temporary tattoos based on some of Allen's real tattoos, as well as a mail-in offer for a poster featuring the artwork of John Wayne Gacy. A bonus feature on the Region 1 DVD shows Allen lying in his coffin for his funeral, dressed in a jacket and jockstrap, as per his own request. At the time of this video, G.G. Allen and the Murder Junkies has a 63% on Rotten Tomatoes and a 7.3 out of 10 on IMDb. The film has adopted a cult status among hardcore punk fans, and although killing, assault, mutilation, or any of the evil that Gacy and Allen represented is nothing to aspire towards, it is nevertheless fascinating to examine and understand the connection between pop culture and its ties to figures notorious for the desire to pervert it.